Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel. So we shall continue with the male reproductive system. So we'll take up the next topic, that is accessory sex glands in the males. So as we have seen that in the male reproductive system, the gonads, that is the testes, they produce the sperm which are conveyed by several duct system. But as these sperms pass through, they must be conveyed through some medium, right? So that medium is provided by the secretions by several accessory sex glands. Okay, so these ducts, they can store these sperms for several months, as we have seen, right? Even if they are not ejaculated, they still remain viable in these duct system. So that is made possible by these several secretions. So these secretions also form the part of the liquid portion of the semen into which the sperms are ejaculated towards the exterior. Okay, so the accessory sex glands, these include the seminal vesicles, the prostate and the bulbourethral gland. So there are three accessory sex glands. Bulbourethral glands are also known as Cowper's gland. So you all must be familiar with these terms, as we have discussed all these as we were discussing the urethra in the urinary system, because the ducts from these glands, they secrete their secretions into the urethra. So we have seen where exactly the openings are. So coming to the first accessory sex gland, that is the seminal vesicles. Okay, seminal vesicles, or these are known as seminal glands. Okay, why? Because these are paired in nature. There are two on either sides. So these, as you can see, the appearance, it is highly coiled, right? So these are convoluted pouch-like structures, and the dimensions are 5 cm in the length, and their location is posterior to the base of the urinary bladder. As you can see, this is the urinary bladder. Now you are looking at it from the posterior side. Okay, so this is the posterior view. So just behind the urinary bladder, at the base of the urinary bladder, on either sides lies these two glands. Okay, that is a paired seminal glands. And these are also anterior to the rectum. So just posterior to these lies the rectum. Okay. Now these glands, they secrete an alkaline fluid like structure, viscous fluid. So this particular fluid is secreted through certain ducts. Remember when we were discussing about the duct system, the ampulla of the ductus deferens or the vas deferens, these are the ones, right? The expanded part, it fuses with the duct from the seminal vesicles, right? So both these empty their secretions into the prostatic urethra, correct? Okay, if you all can recall, okay, through the ejaculatory duct. Okay, so both the ducts from the vas deferens and the seminal vesicle, they join together to form a small duct called as ejaculatory duct, right? So the secretions from the seminal vesicles, they will be entering into the ejaculatory duct, and through here it will enter into the prostatic urethra. Now coming to the composition of the secretions of this particular gland, so this include fructose, it's a monosaccharide, as you are all aware of. Then the next component is the prostaglandins and the clotting proteins. Now these clotting proteins are not the same as that which are present in the blood. These are slightly different. Now as we have seen that the secretions are alkaline in nature. Now the advantage of this alkalinity is that it helps in neutralizing the acidic environment in the urethra. Now urethra, what is the main function? To convey the urine which is stored into the urinary bladder towards the exterior, right? We have seen the three parts. Now the environment in the urethra will be naturally acidic because it is carrying the urine. So sperms are not able to survive in the acidic pH. Okay, otherwise they will get inactivated and killed. So to prevent that, this particular secretion from the seminal vesicles, it is alkaline in nature, so it helps in neutralizing the acidity which is present over here in the urethra as well as in the female reproductive tract. Okay, then the coming to the functions of the components, the fructose, it is utilized for ATP production. Now, why ATP is required? For the energy source, right? So it's an energy source, so it is utilized. Fructose is utilized for the ATP production by the sperm, which will help in the motility. The next component is the prostaglandin. So prostaglandin, it contributes to the motility as well as viability of the sperms. Also, it may stimulate the contractions of the smooth muscles within the female reproductive tract. So that will again aid in movement of the sperm through the female reproductive tract. Okay. Then the clotting factor or the clotting proteins which are present in the semen. Obviously, their role will be coagulation, right? So it helps in coagulation of the semen after the ejaculation has taken place. Okay. Now the fluids which are secreted by these glands, they contribute round about 60% of the volume of the semen. Then the next gland is prostate. Okay, prostate, it is a single gland. Okay, the actual meaning of this term, how it was derived, is prostata means one who stands before. Okay, so this particular gland, as you can see, this is the one, prostate gland. Okay, so as you can see that it is roughly a dunnet shape, right? Dunnet shaped gland. It is not exactly round in shape, a little bit flattened in shape. Round about size of golf ball. Okay, the measurements are variable. Say it is 4 centimeters from side to side. That is this dimension. It is 4 centimeters. Then from top to bottom, it is 3 centimeters. And from front to back, it is 2 centimeters. Okay, and as you can see, the location it is just inferior to the urinary bladder. Just below the urinary bladder it is located and it surrounds the prostatic urethra. So as the urethra is passing through prostate, it is known as prostatic urethra. Okay, now this particular gland, it has a peculiarity in that it increases in size very slowly, right from the birth to the puberty. But after puberty, it will expand very rapidly until the age of 30. Okay, so at this particular age, the growth, it remains the stable. Okay, so it does not grow in size until the person's age is 45 years. Okay, and after this age, again further enlargement of the gland may take place. Now coming to the secretions, again this particular gland, it secretes a milky but slightly acidic fluid. Now here the pH is little bit acidic. Now coming to the components and their role, first one is the citric acid. So citric acid, it is utilized for the ATP production via the Krebs cycle for generation of the ATP by the sperms. Then there are several proteolytic enzymes such as prostate specific antigen, pepsinogen, lysozyme, amylase, hyaluronidase. So all of them help in breakdown of the clotting proteins which are released by the seminal vesicles. Then acid phosphatase is also released, but its function is not yet known. Next component is the seminal plasmin. This is an antibiotic, so it will destroy the bacteria. Okay, so this will help in decreasing the amount or number of the bacteria which may be present in the semen or in the lower female reproductive tract. Okay. Then the secretions, they enter the urethra through many prosthetic ducts, and the amount which it contributes, it is round about 25% of the volume of the semen, and its role is to help in the motility and viability of the sperms again. Next gland is bulbourethral gland. So this is again a paired gland. As you can see, there are two which are present on either sides. Okay, so these glands are also known as Köppel glands. These are about the size of peas. Okay, and they are located just inferior to the prostate gland on the either side of the membranous urethra, within the deep muscles of the perineum, and their ducts open into the spongy urethra, the one which passes through the penis. Okay. Now this particular gland, it secretes an alkaline fluid during the sexual arousal. So this alkaline fluid will again help in protecting the sperms which are passing by neutralizing the acids of the urine which is present in the urethra. So acidic environment can be neutralized by the alkaline secretion. Also they secrete the mucus which helps in lubrication of the end of the penis and also the linings of the urethra, so that as the sperms are passing they prevent their damage as they are being ejaculated out towards the exterior. Even during the arousal, small amount of this secretion it is released upon the sexual arousal or the erection, but this particular secretion, it actually does not contain these sperms. Okay, so this is to do with the accessory sex glands, that is the seminal vesicles, then the prostate and the bulbourethral glands, or these are also known as Köppel's gland. Okay, this is the reference. Thank you for watching.